So dito naman tayo. A two-force congruent system is acting on a three-dimensional plane, Z as the vertical axis. So mabuti sa problem na to, sinabi kung ano yung vertical axis para hindi na tayo ma-confuse. So F1 is 10 kN applied along the XZ plane, and then acting upward with an angle of 67 degrees from the X axis. And F2 is 20 kN applied along the YZ plane, acting upward with an angle of 60 degrees from the horizontal. And so first, let's try to draw the figure muna. So Z yung vertical axis daw. Add na lang tayo ng shapes. Yan, 3D. So, the vertical axis is Z daw. So, ano na lang, ito na lang yung X ko, ito naman yung Y. You can interchange them kasi the same lang din yung components niya. So, F1 daw is 10 kN applied along the XZ plane. So, ito yung XZ plane. Yan. So, meron daw 10 kN applied dyan. So, sabihin natin, from here, merong 10 kN. Yan. So, 10 kN, and then, meron daw siyang inclination na 67 degrees from the x-axis. So, ito pala, yung angle na yan, 67 degrees. And then, F2 naman is 20 kN applied along the positive YZ plane, acting upward. So, yung YZ plane is this one. Yan. So, we have a force of 20 kN daw, acting upward. Yan. So, 20 kN. And then, it has an angle of 60 degrees from the Y axis. So, this is 60 pala. Yan. So, since nakahiga yan sa XZ plane, ibig sabihin, meron siyang components along X and along Z, but walang component along Y. Itong 20 kN naman, it has a component along Y and along Z, but wala siyang component along X. So, we can now sum up forces. Sum up natin yung forces along X. So, we have negative 10. Ito lang yung, let's just assume na ito yung, pa-forward pala ito, no? Pa-forward. So, ito yung positive direction ko sa x-axis. Ito naman sa y. And then, upward sa z is positive. So, summation of forces along x, we have this force going toward the positive direction. So, plus lang yan, 10. Cosine of 67 to get the component along X. Yan. So, ito lang. And then, let's sum up forces along Y. So, along Y, we have 20 cosine 60. Yan. And then, for FZ naman, yung dalawang forces natin, meron silang components along Z. And then, all acting upward. So, summation of FZ, we have 10 sine 67 plus 20 sine 60. Yan. So, sum up natin. 10 cos 67 3.907, and then 20 cos 60 is 10, and then ito naman, this is 10 sine 67 plus 20 sine 60. Yan. So 26.53. Lahat yan sila kian. Yan. So the first question is, ano daw yung resultant ng force system? Ito yung first natin makukuha. So we have F equals square root of Fx squared plus Fy squared plus Fz squared. So square root of 3.907 squared plus 10 squared plus 26.53. Yan. So, n squared na lang plus 10 squared plus 3.907 squared. We have 28.62. Yan. Ito na yung resultant natin. So, ito pala. Letter A pala. Yan. And then, sa first question naman, ano yung angle between the resultant and the y-axis? Ito yung gagawin natin. Mag-cosine tayo, and then phi y. Again, just review the first part of this. Yung statics practice problems part 1, kasi andun yung explanation dito. So this is equal to the y component, which is 10 positive divided by 28.62. so arccos 10 over 28.62, this is 69.55. Yan. So, letter C pala. Yan na yung sagot natin. Music.